You've dealt with President Trump before when he was just the businessman. I remember you famously telling me about it when we were in Azerbaijan together, about the negotiations and, you know, Trump wanting his name on literally everything you said, possibly even the toilet paper. Your thoughts on how he's handled the U.S.'s response so far?
I think he's done a fantastic job. I'm probably his biggest supporter. He's doing a super, super, super job, and it's not an easy job. You can guarantee whatever he says, people will say he's wrong. I think he's coming out looking and being completely honest with the information which he's received. He can own, I mean, what he's been saying is obviously information he's got from other people. He's not an inventor, so he hasn't invented this virus. So he can't say it's only going to be for so long. I think Donald's a little bit more straightforward and a bit more forceful. And I think people, and I hope they believe him, because I don't think he would tell things that aren't true.
And you, through your position for a long time, traveled the globe, meeting with world leaders. From your experience, what are the qualities in a world leader from your personal interactions with them that really helps in a time like this?
Well, I think whether it's a time like this and any other team, I think for somebody to be a good leader, they've got to be able to make decisions, just as simple as that, and quick decisions, not things they have to think about for 2 days and that are influenced by other people. They have to answer immediately.
Your view on dictatorships versus democracy in some cases, right?
Completely. I think if I was in charge of the world, I think I'd put Mr. Putin in charge of the world. He makes decisions, and he's one that can sort out the facts from people that are telling him rubbish. I mean, it's a great shame that that the world, people in the world can't really get to know him, because he's a very, very nice, sensible person.